Hello, welcome back to another video, and today, you guys remember cassette tapes. Nobody does, but cassette tapes, right? These things, the cassette tapes, right? Well, do you remember the thing that replaced these CDs, and then that was replaced by an iPod, which nobody uses any of those things anymore, and then the iPod was replaced by the iPod Touch, which they still make today, and I bought one, the newest iPod, and it's really great, and I definitely recommend, if you haven't, go buy one of the new iPods that Apple released, because they're really good, and you won't be disappointed. Also, this is only a temporary filming spot, as I am setting up an area to film these kinds of videos. Yeah, anyway, so you're probably wondering where I got this from. So you're probably thinking that this came out, like, a long time ago, and I've been able to just find one in somewhat good condition. Well, what about if I told you that I bought this not that long ago, brand new from Walmart, 2019. I bought it a couple days ago. Yeah, Walmart still makes cassette tapes. And who uses cassette tapes anymore? I mean, honestly, I don't think anyone uses them except people that still do. Now, if Walmart is listening to this, don't stop selling these because I think this is really cool and kind of funny that Walmart still sells cassette tapes. But what I'm curious, so it says that we can record for 90 minutes. Now, I know that, I don't know the original price, but I know that the better ones were more expensive, like $8 for one cassette tape. I got these two for $3, so who knows what the quality is going to be. But honestly, I think that Walmart's pretty much the only company that still sells cassette tapes and new. So honestly, I don't know. People that are still looking to buy cassette tapes are going to buy the older ones that don't have anything on them, or are just going to use the ones that they've already got. Not many people, I don't know how many people honestly are going to buy these, but the fact that they sell this is really cool. And Walmart, do not stop selling these things. Please, just don't stop selling cassette tapes, because it's just funny and kind of cool. I wonder if anyone buys these and genuinely uses these anymore, because I bought this just because it was funny, but there actually wasn't that many left. Anyway, we need to get into this, so we're just going to on butter knife. There we go. We've got a little plastic layer on them. There we go. Scissors. Wait, so we need to basically tighten this up, because if you don't, it can stretch and break the thing. Now, from what I've been told, that basically the nice high quality ones were like $8 and the cheap disgusting ones were like $3 for a load of them. So, and they broke, the cheap ones broke really easily, and you could only record on them like once, maybe twice, and they just broke really easily. So I want to see if it's the same thing with this one, which means we're going to need a cassette player, which means I've got to go looking for a cassette player, but I think I know where one is. Let's get this other one open. Actually, do we need to open this one? No. Oh, wait, what's this? Walmart. Okay. Get out. Get out. Out. Thank you. Okay. So what does it say here? So basically what you can do is you can write down all the songs. You can write like A, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, okay. So I don't know how high quality these ones are. I didn't read the packaging that much. I've had these for a little bit, like I said. Yeah. Okay, so I need to go grab a cassette. And the best way, because I need to record something on this. And I think the most easiest way is just using a radio that has a cassette player and hitting record and just letting this thing do its work for a little bit. So I'm going to go grab that and I'll be back. All right, so we got this thing right here, which as you can see has a radio and a cassette. So I think it can it record. Yes, it can. Yeah, okay. It does have a little record button, so we can record. So we're going to just unplug you. In. Okay. And oh, there we go. We got something. Is there a stop? Okay. All right, we need our cassette player, our cassette here. So we're gonna just, what's in here? There is something in there. Okay. I'm gonna close you. Put you in here. Nice and I put it in wrong. Now we need to figure out how to turn the radio on. Oh, two. Okay, I'm gonna find a song and get this thing recording, and we'll be back in a little. Working. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna switch it to tape, and we're gonna hit play. Music. Record. Are you is this recording? I'm not sure. I don't know. Okay, I'm confused. What the hell is going on? I need to tighten this up. Hold on. Oh, jeez. Okay, it's clear that right now I have no clue what I'm doing. Let's see. Okay, that goes down fine. But that goes down. So, record. 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 Eject. Turn this way. Pop in. Record. FM. Now record. Record. Is it doing anything? So, move it to tape. Now play. Play something. It broke it. So originally, I stopped filming that video. And I sat down and spent a good hour just trying to get something to record onto this stupid thing. Well, when the thing I was using didn't work, and this, I went over to this thing. And this stupid thing ate the tape. It did it not once, but twice, and I was stupid enough to put it back in a second time. Yes, I mean, look, it didn't rip it in half like it looks. What happened is it got so jammed up in there that we ended up having to cut it. So, I was mad at this point, and I was pretty sure that these were a piece of crap. These things. Oh, by the way, I don't think you're supposed to touch those. I think this has lead in it, so, you know, don't need that. Anyway, so then I tried this tape, which is one from, like, I'm guessing the 80s. I don't know. There's Halloween stuff on here, apparently. Anyway, I tried it. It ate the tape, too. We almost had to cut this one, but luckily we didn't. So we can determine that this stupid piece of crap was eating the tape. Basically, I couldn't get anything to record off of this onto this stupid tape, even though I was playing the radio and hit the record button. It wasn't doing shit. So I switched over to this thing and started recording on this. It didn't work on here, ate the tape, destroyed it. Yeah. I only saved that just to show it. So, at this point, I was pretty sure that I wasn't going to be able to show you guys a working tape, and I was going to turn this video into me ranting about how bad this thing is, but then, I opened up the next one. So I got this other tape out, and I opened it. And so I unsealed it, blah, blah, blah. That one's in that case. So I put this one, so I put it in here. I hit FM radio. Sure. Don't know how this works, you tuned it into what you want. Blah, 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 copyright. Anyway, so I hit record and I just let it play. Then I ejected, it didn't do anything at first. So I was like, okay, it's not recording, what am I doing wrong? Then I read right here that it says playback and record in place. So I stuck it in here, because this one only records here and plays here. So I tried it over here, popped it in, and this is what happened. That crap quality is because I decided it'd be fun to record with the cassette tape and mess with the dial. Don't do that. That just does this. That is not a good description of how the quality is on this. Anyway, so it recorded something. So when I figured out it recorded, I recorded a bunch of other junk on it. So now this thing is mildly not really that full of anything at this moment. So yeah, I'm going to play this in a second and I can show you what I put on it. Anyway, this thing did do the unravel thing and get stuck in there once. Luckily, I was able to fix it. This thing. I want to tear it apart. Look, I only kept it just because I wanted to show you. Basically, what happens is this thing has this in here. And it pulls along and wraps in there. And gets played by those little things. See? So we're gonna just stick one there. Don't do this. Put it in the wrong set. Oh, jeez. Okay. Hey, it's up, judge. Oh, jeez. Doesn't sound like crap. 100%, you know, Spotify's better than this, but it works, I guess. Nobody's gonna use these, so I don't know. I unsealed two of these crappy things, and one of them broke. The other one now sits in this thing called Walmart for some reason. And this tape works. I can record pretty much anything I want to on this. The quality actually doesn't sound terrible. I mean, it's radio quality, so onto a cheap cassette tape. So it's the equivalent of worse than CD quality. But, you know, it works, I guess, technically. I mean, it doesn't really matter at the end of the day. Nobody's going to use this stuff. I mean, most people probably don't even know what cassette tape is or even have a player that can play it. I mean, there's a more... You can't even record from your phone to this thing, I think. I'm trying to figure that out. Without going to burning the song onto a CD, then burning that onto from a radio, or burning the CD somehow onto the cassette tape, so your quality is going to be Spotify mixed with CD quality put onto a radio with a cassette tape. And that's a lot of effort, so this was the easiest way. I don't know. It works. That's all I can say. It plays music. It finally records. I don't know why it wasn't doing that from the beginning, but only wasted me a whole tape. Stupid thing. And broken. I don't know. Just, you can click off the video. This is pretty much the end of the review at this point. I'm just gonna let the song finish. Probably say something dumb, and then the video will be over. I mean, if you look at it right here, see what I mean? That's how it gets shriveled up. It gets caught, I'm guessing. Just as you look at it, closes. Okay. And, I mean, if we reverse it to the very beginning, I kind of just put a mashup of songs on here.